And also led to like a terrible lifestyle, just on my part, because I was traveling just being on the road all the time, kind of dealing with stress, and also eating this terrible food, eventually started getting me problems in my stomach. And I didn't know what the problems were. For 10 years, 12 years, maybe even 15 years, I dealt with this problem before I ever went to see a doctor. And so I'm going to tell you at first my symptoms, because you might not know you have this problem like I didn't know I had this problem. And so at first, I would get kind of bloated and uncomfortable, maybe nauseous. After every meal, every time I ate a meal, I'd get nauseous and uncomfortable, and I'd have to belch, I'd have to burp, but look, and I had to do this a few times. As the years progressed, you know, 2 years later, 4 years later, 6 years later, 10 years later, it started to get worse and worse, and so where I had to start belching and burping more after every meal, and I was more uncomfortable after every meal. And it got so bad to the point where pretty much I didn't want to eat food no more, because it just made me feel terrible every time I ate. And what ended up happening, this kind of cycle developed where I had to eat because if I didn't eat, I would get sick. But at the same time, I didn't want to eat because food made me sick. It was like a terrible cycle that I was in. And so eventually, this belching after every meal ended up sometimes turning into vomiting. So whenever I would eat, then I'd have to throw up. I'd have to vomit, I'd have to puke, I'd have to throw up all my food. It made me feel too uncomfortable and too nauseous to keep it inside of me. And then eventually when it got really bad, you know, 10 years, 12 years down the line, I started to bleed. I would be bleeding when I'd be vomiting. There'd be blood in my vomit. And I couldn't really sleep at night because if I didn't eat every like 4 hours, I'd get very sick. And I'd have this problem where I'd have to go vomit or throw up. It was a terrible cycle to be in. And so when I'm asleep, I can't eat because I'm trying to sleep. So I can never sleep for more than 4 hours because I wake up and have to go to the restroom and go vomit. Because if I didn't eat after 4 hours, that would make me sick too. So it's like, no matter what, I'm sick all the time. Always throwing up, always in the restroom. It was hard for me to be out in public. And so as many of you have witnessed today, I have a booth up here for OG Labs, my company, and I've been out here all day. I haven't gone to the restroom one time and throw up to vomit. I haven't really eaten consistently. I've had one meal and a few snacks, you know. Normally, I would be so sick right now, I wouldn't be able to do this. I'd be throwing up, I'd be vomiting. And so, basically, I went to the doctors, and they were no help. The doctors pretended to not know what was wrong with me. They do this with every Crohn's patient. They always pretend not to know what's wrong with you. Pretend you have to run a million tests to see what's wrong. And each one of these tests costs $10,000 or 10,000 euros. And at this point in time, I had kind of already learned about cannabis oil because I was filming a documentary in Colorado called Illegally Alive. You can watch this for free. It's on YouTube. Illegally Alive. It's a feature-length documentary film about families who had to relocate from illegal states in the United States to Colorado in order to get access to medical cannabis for their children most of the time. And so the main character in my film, his name is Colin Turner, he had Crohn's disease. And at this point in time when I'm filming this movie, I'm actually out with Colin. We're going to Illinois, to where he's from, and I'm traveling with him and his family. And on this road trip in their suburban, I end up having to vomit 4 or 6 times. You know, I have to tell them, pull over, I'm not feeling bad, I'm not sick, I gotta throw up, please pull over. I'm more sick than the main character in my film. So that's when I really found out that I have all the symptoms that he has. And what he uses is a tincture, and that kind of puts his symptoms at bay. He uses a tincture, which what I call a tincture is like the pure form of from cannabis oil mixed with carrier oil. Like I mix RCBD oil, RCBD tincture, really I mix it with hemp seed oil. A lot of people use MCT oil, coconut oil, these kind of things. That's what he uses, you know, to keep his symptoms away. And so it works for him. To be honest, I never really tried the tinctures, because at the same time when I'm filming this documentary, I'm doing a ton of research about cannabis and all the different ways it can help with different diseases it can help. And then this is when I hear about Rick Simpson. I hear about Rick Simpson oil, Arzo, Phoenix Tears. I hear about this oil that can cure cancer. And so I think, well, if this oil is strong enough to cure cancer, well, what can it do for my Crohn's disease? You know, it doesn't hurt. Maybe I should try it. And so at this point in time, I actually flew out to see Rick in Croatia to film in the movie I was filming. I filmed an interview with him, and he saw me in this terrible condition that I am in, throwing up. And he's like, Mike, you really need to get on this oil, brother. And so that was really kind of the kick in the butt I needed. At that point in time, I wasn't taking the oil consistently. And I learned how to make it, but he kind of helped me with the questions I had filling in the gaps that I didn't know how to make, or, you know, tips I needed and things like that. So I went back to the United States and I took this oil consistently. I took 90 grams in 120 days. So 90 grams of oil in 4 months. I grew this myself. I grew these plants myself. So I knew exactly what was in them. I knew that there was no pesticides. And it was grown organically, this quality cannabis. After that, I processed it myself also into my own cannabis oil. So all the oil I took was my own. Now today, I don't have any of the symptoms that I used to have. My symptoms really disappeared from the first time I started taking it. So since 2014, when I started taking this, I would be throwing up or vomiting maybe 30 times a day. Yeah, that's average, 30 times a day. Since 2014, in the last 5 years, I've vomited maybe 5 times total, once per year. So from 30 times per day, I've thrown up once per year. It's a complete 90-day difference. And a lot of people will ask, well, if you still take the oil today, you know, are you cured? And yeah, I do take the oil today. I say that here because in the dictionary, I've gotten into this with a few other activists. It doesn't say anything about dosing in the dictionary. It says about curing the disease. It says just to relieve someone of their symptoms. And so since day one, the oil has completely relieved me of my symptoms. Today, I take about 3 grams every month. So a little more than the 1 gram per month maintenance dose that is advertised out there. I take 3. And I take it as needed. So I don't have like a set time I take the oil. I still eat bad sometimes. I'm on the road traveling still. So sometimes I do eat bad, even though I try my hardest not to do it. I do have a glass of wine every now and then that can aggravate my symptoms also. So I take the oil, you know, beforehand, and that fixes everything for me, or I take it afterwards if I have problems. And then I guess this fast forward 5 years after I started telling everybody this in Colorado, in 2014, that I cured myself from Crohn's disease, everyone started messaging me and sending me a message saying, hey, my mother needs oil, or my brother needs oil, or my sister needs oil, or my father needs oil, or my cousin needs oil, or I need oil because I have cancer, or I have a brain tumor, or I have arthritis, or I have Alzheimer's, or COPD. And had everyone messaging me about every disease at this point in my time. And I've made the oil for everyone who's asked. Everyone who's asked me, been able to provide me the funds in order to buy the materials to make it. I make it at cost, and I've made it for them. So at this point, I've distributed to over 2,000 people, and I don't even know how many countries. I stopped counting how many countries I've sent the oil to. And it's the high THC oil I'm talking about. And the reason I sent it to you was because I'm a patient. You know, and so I'm in medical relief. I pay for the plant. And a lot of other people out there, they'll charge to 150 euros per gram for this oil, and I sell for 30 euros per gram. I try to really do it for this as cheap as I can, and I want to get it to as many people's hands as I can. Besides that, I have a show online, educational show. Like I mentioned, my movie is available to watch for free online. I have a show where we have a few episodes of Christmas, and I have videos on how to make the oil yourself, videos how to make tinctures, how to make lotions, tips on how to grow, cloning, different things you might want to know. I'll make a video on it. If there's another video I have, send me a message and I'll make a video about it. I really believe in education, and this is actually kind of a little bit of a terrible thing I have to share with you guys, but my page was on Facebook. My main page was on Facebook. I had 63,000 followers. Some of my videos had over a million views, and they were all videos about patients healing themselves with cannabis. Well, about 3 weeks ago, that page was completely shut down. All of my profiles were shut down. That I just kept with my friends. And anything that said my lies on Facebook was completely shut down. And in pages that I started, pages that were not related, I had a page about my movie, I had a page about Ocean Labs, my company, I had another page about print reading, print articles about cannabis activism. These were all shut down at the same time without a warning. You know, so many other people have their pages shut down and tell, oh, you're spamming, you can send us an appeal. My page has been completely deleted. I've gone to the offices in Warsaw, in Poland, I've gone to the Facebook offices, they refuse to talk with me. And it's just, you know, disturbing to me because there's nothing but educational material on my page. That's what I focus on, is educating people. But at the same time, we have pages like High Times and Dab Stars and Now This Key that are putting out videos of people like doing dabs on their nose and smoking concentrates. And like, this promoting a bunch of CBD or all this kind of sensational stuff, and they're allowed to keep going out there because they're talking about cannabis. But if I want to talk about educating and healing yourself with a plant, my page is shut down. And so I guess the takeaway I want to leave you guys with before I get into questions is that now that you've heard my story and you know a little bit more about me, you know that I'm just like one of you guys. And to know that this punk kid skateboarder has helped 2,000 people cure themselves from all sorts of diseases, you know, that means that you can do the same thing too. And it's pretty simple. All you have to do is plant a seed in your garden. You know what I mean? And you can make this oil yourself at home. The only thing that keeps us from doing it is bureaucrats and politicians and capitalists and capitalists. And that's something I'll get into in another day. So I guess we'll go into questions now. If you guys want to chat about anything, ask anything about cannabis, let's do it. He was my doctor helped. But science had another good friend of mine, Shona Benda, had Crohn's disease, and I had done a lot of filming with her, and we talked a lot about this. And she actually used Rick Simpson to cure her Crohn's disease, but she's also done tons of surgeries, and so she couldn't fully cure her disease. So at this point, I started putting one and one together, and now I've come to the conclusion, even though I did have it then, is that once you treat these surgeries for Crohn's disease, there's no coming back from this. You cannot regrow an organ that they take out from you. So with cannabis oil, it really works like a key in a lock to, you know, the scientific way. It hits your receptors and it tells your organs to function correctly. So once you start taking this oil, and the other thing I really didn't mention is I started eating right too. So when I took this oil for 120 days, I cut out pretty much all sugars, all carbohydrates. I was eating nothing but leafy greens and pretty vegetables, bright-colored vegetables, doing a lot of juicing, eating salads, and this kind of thing. Now it's when I've kind of regressed a little bit, which is why I take the oil 3 grams per month. I don't eat salads all the time like I used to. So the combination that I found and why I didn't go with the doctors and the surgeons is because I learned that by eating healthy and taking cannabis oil, you can control your symptoms completely. So I went that route instead. We've moved, we have labs in Amsterdam, well, an hour near Amsterdam in Nova Labs, where we could get oral tested at any time we want. And so, I guess, to answer your question is no, my oral was not tested. I grew it myself, and I processed it myself. And why I like to talk about this and mention this so often is that, you know, labs in this case were not necessary. You know, a laboratory was not necessary. You can do this at home. You know, that's really when I push to people, and that's why I put videos about how to make the oil and how to grow it yourself, is because this kind of laboratories and doctors, you know, we keep talking about wine and go to the doctors. These people are all part of a system that keeps cannabis illegal. Every day, people in these industries work hard to make sure people like me and you don't grow cannabis, you know? So I try to really push this message of self-reliance, that you can do this yourself because you can. You know, I'm not special. You're welcome.
Tem mais alguma questão?
Yeah, me too. Me too. From skateboarding.
Then basically, I was wondering if you guys have actually gotten into exploring, like, for example, relationships that cannabis has with other sorts of plants that can help, like, more topically, I guess. Like, the one that she gave me had arnica, comfrey, cannabis, it was mixed with, like, organic bee, wax, and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. Not many people actually know this, but Rick Simpson, when he made the oil and cured his cancer, he had skin cancer. So he did it topically. And then later started ingesting it. And so there really is ways that your skin can absorb it. A kind of a funny, it's funny to me, but really people take this very seriously. And it is serious. Is your belly button is also a place where you can kind of put the oil and it will absorb it. But what I recommend in this case is to do both. To do a treatment where you can combine a topical rub with a lotion and also one that you ingest orally or via suppository. And this oil you can make yourself. The basic way that I describe it in my video is with the raw cannabis oil and coconut oil. And it's super easy to do at home with no fancy tools. No problem. That's actually another really good question. And in this case, I can really only speak in my own experience. I only deal with high THC oil when it's any condition that's a serious condition that you can die from. So if it's terminal and you can die from this disease, then I always recommend THC oil. Maybe the indica plant instead of a sativa plant. Indica plants rest and sleep, which is what you need when you're healing. And the reason why is that other people that I know who make oil around the world, I had the opportunity to speak with them at kind of the time that I was learning about making oil myself and taking it. And these people had told me that they had given CBD oil to people with these conditions, and that the CBD oil did not work, it was not strong enough, and that these people unfortunately ended up losing their lives and passing away. So THC is what works for pretty much every condition that we've seen. The one we talk about that varies, and it really is only one, is a breast cancer-related disease that's hormone-driven. They call this ER-positive or ER-receptive cancer. And in this case, we recommend to take high CBD and high THC oil. Different people out there on the internet might tell you to take a 3-to-1 CBD or something that's lower in THC and high in CBD. With the people I've spoken with, they've tried this, and this does not work with their patients either. You know, and so for some female people, specifically in Canada, passed away from using a high CBD oil to treat this. So they say, many people say a 1-to-1, but I just say high THC oil, high CBD, turn it as much of both as you can. So Labs is the name of my company. You can find it. It's near the entrance on the left. Also, you can always send me a message. Like I said, YouTube. I did make a new Facebook. And actually, a bit of good news is that I was able to recover my public figure page. So you can go to Facebook and type in Michael Wise, activist and filmmaker. And I have like 21,000. So I still have kind of a little bit of following on there. You can send me a message. And I answer all messages. I never charge people for answering messages. I do it for free. I always have. Sometimes I'll warn you, it might take a week or two. But I will get to the other message. You can message me then. Check my show out if you haven't. YouTube is the place to go now. Mike Wise Show. I'm on Instagram. Mike Wise Show, like a TV show. Yeah, check it out and, you know, keep finding, keep supporting activists, other activists, local activists. If they need help in your area, try to help them as much as they can. If they need time, volunteering, money, whatever you can give activists that are trying to accomplish change with cannabis in your area, try to help them. And on that note, I want to thank everyone here at Cannadouro, you guys specifically, the organizers, everyone who helps put this together. And thank you guys for inviting me out to speak with you guys, because I've had a great time.
Thank you very much, Mike, for joining us and for all the very relevant